Hello everybody and welcome to Smarace.tv's coverage of a very, very, very special event. Oh, it's a treat. Treat for all. We're here today about to test out a new spiffy mod. It's a GT3 one, excuse me. I've just been eating garlic kebabs. So apologies if the smell is reeking through. But I had a thought. Like some people who have been able to have a day off work because it's Crimbo, I had to go in. We're here today for Simrace.tv's coverage of the GT3 Endurance Multi-League 2010. Where am I? Let's do time off again. And we're here at Brno. That little known Jet Jack. Just waiting for everyone to join the server. We've had a couple of mini technical hitches, as you come to expect from new leagues. I'll be conducting cameras today, so you could all possibly just keep your eyes closed. That could work quite nicely. And if you fancy a good comical affair, I believe there's a German stream going on next door. Not quite sure what stream they are on though, so I shall take a little looky. Oh, there's no one in there. If only they'd done that in 1939 and just not turned up. How different would the world be? So, maybe it is because it is German, but I'm not entirely sure. We've got a whole night of entertainment. We've got multi-greets. We've got a 90-minute feature race. I've got enough drink to survive me the evening. I hope you've all got enough snacks as well to keep yourself amused. Because I haven't got a foggy. I'm also, just so that everyone knows, viewing this through someone else's screen. So I may be a little bit confused and a little bit not quite on the ball. We're going to be moving forward to a 20-minute qualifying session first though, which is just clicking through right now. Let's see what we got cooking. Ta-da. Ta-da. See, aren't you riveted? I have no other timing screens on my banners apart from what is here, so if there's something exciting going off and you can't see it on the screen and I can't see it on any of the monitors, tough. To be fair. Yeah, we've got a 20-minute session to try and get whoever's got the best of stuff going on. I can't even read that name. There's an interesting side note actually. Someone's got a whisper on me in TeamSpeak and they've not actually spoke yet. They've just done a lot of heavy breathing. So I might be slapped with a very large bill at the end of this. So welcome then to the all-new GT3 mod. Let's get some showcasing on the road. You can see everyone's bounded straight out onto the track for qualification. try and get themselves the best grid possible for the race itself. And we're following round. Here is that. Oh, someone is about to run into the rear of the car in front, whoever it was. It's not good at all. That's Mr. Krause. That livery looks like funky. We're doing a lot of showcasing of liveries, I think, today, just because I don't know who the names are. I don't really know who my name is. Oh, that looks suspiciously spikery. It's Simunik. They're just taking a little bit of slipstreaming action. You get a little feel for the Bruno circuit itself. That's not the racing line. A little bit wide there, my friend. Come back. Full of good elevation, banked curves. Kind of very reminiscent, I think, of a modern day Zandvoort. So, let's see what is cooking. I come over the hill. I think this is going to be. Ooh, that's not going to work at all, and that's contact. Who was that? That wasn't very good at all. Round goes poor Simunik. I don't think he'll be impressed. He's got back going again. But that car's going to be a little bit worse for wear. I wonder if he's going to drag himself back to the pit lane. There we go. We're 3 minutes into qualification. We're already having bad driving. Don't you just love sim racing? So, got that's out on a lap. Let's go back to Krause, who I think may have been potentially one of the guys involved in that. So that seems to be quite a lot of this funky white and red livery. I must say this mod does look quite sexy. Keep on going at this rate, I could be tenting. And he's just weaving his way quite nicely around the opening sector. You can attack the curbs around this track. Fine effort indeed. Didn't get to see who was on top form. Oh, that's not quite good at all. A little bit nose heavy, Barry Manilow style, but he's collected it back up again. And Krause has been not quite troubling the complete apex there, but it's been an aggressive and gutsy lap so far. He doesn't appear to have dropped too much time from the cars ahead. Racing car in the background there appears to have closed ever so slightly, and whoever that is in front of them just locking up as we come round the final few corners. And I think that was Piccolo there, 157.5, setting the benchmark to begin with. You can see everyone else just starting to pound in the 2 minute mark. Krause there, 1.6 seconds down so far. Round into the final couple of corners, very very short final sector, and across the line he comes. Do you like that camera? Let's say 159.5, best fifth position just so far. Let's see who else is out and about. Is that a new track? Oh, it's all going on. This is a qualification lap, and oh my goodness, free ride into the corner. That's never going to work. And who on earth decided that that would be good to do? That is awful. And there you can say they're a litter or a tip. It might be a litter, I don't know. Just rejoining on the track again, I suppose. He might as well just go back round again. He's 11 seconds off of the pace. Well, a little bit of bad driving, and that car's looking a little bit dodgy. I suppose we're getting to see the damage physics in quite good form. Oh dear, who's that busy trying to avoid a litter just up ahead there? was that? That Coughlin. I can read that name. That Kyle, by any chance. Sounds gay. He's 3.2 down. He's got a couple of cars that he's starting to bottle up behind. A red one and a yellow one. I thought I was colourblind. Piccolo's still there on top with a 157.173 as the cars filter their way through these last couple of corners once again. Let's see what these lot do. Hoffman across the line, and that's a 202 down in 18th position. That won't do him many favours. So who's that that's popped up into 4th position? Langan, they're up into 4th. 1.2 down. So Piccolo there. He's back out again in that sexy looking car. He's 7 hundredths down after the first split. Let's jump on board. If I press all the buttons, we will get there eventually. And let's just see exactly what Piccolo is doing to annihilate the opposition. No one else is really close, just Kony is in second position now. Most drivers have set a time so far. That's good. See, really attacking the curbs a lot more than everyone else around some of these corners. But is it paying off? It doesn't look like it. This is looking like a much slower lap. Yeah, 3 seconds down. I don't quite know what Piccolo's up to. Maybe he's just on a warming down one, but at least we've been able to get some onboard footage with our current pole sitter. Second currently then is Koenig, and he's 65 thousandths of a second down, so he's a little bit better than what Piccolo was last time round on this split. Let's see what he's doing, interestingly, in the same liveried car. That'll be interesting to see if that car is deemed to be performance-wise better around this type of circuit, as he's in very deep, just locking the brakes and snatching one of them. And back up the hill he doth go. A little bit of traffic up ahead, although they're quite... That camera angle is a little bit deceiving, actually, a little bit further away than I thought. He's a tenth down, or just well, 1.5 tenths down, so he's slipping back again, but he seems to be the only one that's holding a candle at the moment to Piccolo during this qualification session. He's still got 11 minutes 20 seconds left to run round these final couple of corners. He's got his lights on. It's a bit like to me. Yeah, he has. That's not very nice. Pure daylight. Oh, second position. Clawed back some time in the final sector. I wonder if he's sticking his lights on just so that everyone knew to get out of his way because he was on a hot lap. But that's good work there by him. Third position is Gene Lee. What? Is that Gene Lee or Gene T? Gene T sounds better. GMT. Granny drink. And he's just on a out lap there. Fourth currently is Wackerbauer. Wackadays. Yeah, he's busy flashing himself as well. I tell you what, do that in this country, you'll get slapped with a fine. As he's what, just over 2/3 of a second down at the end of the first sector. So that shows the real class that you've got between Piccolo and Koenig. So who's that? Someone moving up into 8th position. With a 158.679. So Wackerbauer there, quite comfy in 4th position so far. See the different gradients that we've got around this circuit. Let's see what he's like at the end of the second sector. We're just past halfway in the quali session. So 1.4 down, this isn't going to be an improvement for Wackerbauer, so we shall move on. Who's in 5th? That is Langan. We've seen him for X Factor. Rowan's in 6th position. I assume that's Fan Canitz in 7th. And he he's not improving with that time. That time's awful. He must be going back into the pits there. Eighth is Rambu, who we just saw improve. He's 2 tenths down at the end of the first sector there, so that's not bad going at all for him. Ninth and 2 seconds off pole, which you'd leave, is Simunic, recovering again. We saw him getting bolted out earlier on in the qualification session. This is looking a little bit more stable. Half a second down nearly at the end of first sector. It's the middle sector where the beef of the track is. The final is just a quick wishy-washy left-right, really, just to finish off the lap. That's someone taking an orienteering expedition just to the side of the track. I think we could be seeing quite a lot of that. Obviously, new mod, it takes a long while to get used to. And, well, we know a lot of people with R-Factor do like to sit there for hours and hours on end tweaking the very, very tiniest of brake balances and biases. Camber. And all of that. They haven't really had the chance with this because this is a new mod, it's new to everyone. I'm bringing it here to you courtesy of simrace.tv. They can see 1.1 down then at the end of Sector 2. So Simunic most definitely looking like he's going to jump up the order with an improvement here. If he can just hold on around his last chicane, nice and tight into the entry. Let's see what he's doing on the exit. Run wide and use all of the kerb and a smidgy bit more if you need it. And it's just looking juicy. What's he got? Stays 9. Improves by a good half second, but stays 9th, so he's all on his own there. 10th is Valenti Fierro. Again, looking at the half second down marks, I think people are just busy getting themselves back up. Strubenz is 11th. Let's see what he's doing at the end of the second sector. Is this looking like an improvement? Oh, he's 1.5 seconds down there, so there's potential here. I'm surprised at how much, actually, Piccolo was able to pull out around that final sector over Simunic, because Simunic didn't really look like he'd done anything wrong. Strubenz there takes a much different line, actually, a much wider line into the opening half of that chicane. Let's see what he does as he crosses the line. Is this an improvement? Oh, really? No. He's down to 13th because that's someone jumping up into 12th. Just behind him, it's Kraus. Like the crouton, you say the best till last. He's getting himself up the order. There's Olsemann. It's in 14th position. He's not looking like he's improving there. 15th is New or Pacho? Yeah, it looks a cool name anyway. 16th is Matt. We've not seen that livery yet, so youth comes over to start his lap. We have just over 1.5 minutes left to go. 17th is Wenzel. 18th is Philipson. 1.2 down at the end of the first sector, that's not good. 19th is Daniel Beck. 20th is Perkot. Let's see what he's like at the end of the first sector. Oh, he's a country miler, that's not going to work at all for him. Funky livery again, though. 21 is Bord, as he crosses the line, stays 21st there, 6.5 seconds off the pace. 20 seconds is Piogo. Fabian, that looks like that. 23rd is Julian Slevenbedel. I'm butchering these names, I'm sure I am. 24 is Hoffman. 1.5 down. Again at the end of Sector 1, someone's jumped up to 7, that's Kraus again. But he's improved his times. 25th motor, and he's not having a good day, is he? As he parks up. I think he's got time to go out and have another run of it. But that's not worked out at all there for Ricardo Alitta. 26th. Caverio. Yep. Just coming round to finish off his lap. Let's see where he goes. I was going to say that car looks suspiciously like a Monster logo. It is. Is this going to be an improvement up the order for current 26th positioned man? Yes, it is. He moves up into 24th. You'll have that under 7 seconds from the pole position time as well. Good improvement. That pushes 27th to me.
Aww.
So, 26 we've got going. Piccolo doesn't, probably gearing himself up for one more run before he finishes. Koenig is out and about, just starting his hot lap. Let's jump on and see what's cooking in the Koenig. Let's see exactly how this track should hopefully be done. Curved as we go round the long sector one, a little bit wobbly and washy on the entry to that corner there. What are we doing against the time? He's 2 tenths down, quarter of a second down at the end of the first sector. So already not looking like his most stellar performance so far in this 20-minute qualifying session. He's got time for one more lap after this one, depending on how he's fueled. Going to do anything at all, but straight liney there. Using the optimal line. It's so good to commentate on other people's onboard laps, because I sit there and go, yeah, done that wrong, done this wrong, done that wrong. Stick me in one of them cars, it'd be backwards in a hedge. This cannon is up into 7, just ahead of Kraus. So it's to battle over row 4 on the grid. And Piccolo's just gone faster with a 157.080. That has pushed the boat out. Koenig there is a second down. Let's see what Wackenbauer is up to. Oh, he's half a second down already at the end of the first sector. He's ahead of Gene Lee, though. Kenneth Gene T. There he is, gearing up for his last attack. Fifth on the grid is Rambu. I will say Rambo by the time this broadcast is finished. Let's see what he's up to. He's a second down, but as we've seen, the leading duo are so far ahead of everyone else, this could still pop him up into a juicy position. Not that fifth isn't juicy enough already.
There's the final corners to go.
Gonna do. Stays fifth. Improvement in time, but not in position. Largon's just retaken sixth position ahead of Ronan, and there's Canitz, who's only half second down at the end of the second sector. This could work very well for Stefan Canitz as he goes over the hill, just the final chicane left to go. Locking of brakes, that's not going to help at all as he comes into the final turn. You've got to take this nice and easy so that you have maximum straight line speed on the attack, and he yoinks, sixth position away from Langdon, whoever it was that was in sixth place.
La la la.
He's set up into 22nd position. It's Philipson. Perkett's just jumped into 20th position, and the checkered flag has fallen. Everyone must complete the laps that they're on. Piccolo is not doing any more. There is only Koenig really left out there to attack and go better, and he's already 4 tenths down at the end of the second sector. I don't think this is going to work for Koenig. He crosses the line. Oh, no, he doesn't at all. He crosses into the barrier. obviously knew that that one wasn't going to work and just maybe done a all or nothing attempt at the final corner, and splat he goes. This is looking good though for Kenneth Genty. Did he cross the line in time though, as Matt pops into 16th position? Did Kenneth do it or not? He's going at it like he thinks he did, because that was a juicy opening sector. Of course, the beef of the lap does appear to be in the middle. Piccolo seems to have found some extra speed in the final sector though. As you can see, just three attempts of the second down into the second sector, over the brow and round a last do-si-do before you cross the line. Once again, hot on the brakes on both of those turns. What can Kenneth do as he pops over the line? Is this good enough to challenge for a higher position? No, he stays fourth position. He improves his time. 8 temps nearly down. A good effort though by Kenneth Genty. Canitz stays 6, Vargon 7. You can see Rein Nedge popping into the pits. He obviously knows he's not going to improve. Kraus is 9, rounding out the top 10. We've got Valenti Ferrero, old Patty himself. So we're just moving forward to the next session. Or are we? Come on. Did everyone have a nice Christmas? I did. Wonder what everyone's doing for New Year. I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing for New Year yet. I think there'll be definite alcohol involved. In fact, there'll be definite lots of stuff involved. So, while I can actually read some of these names, I'm going to go through them because I apologise in advance. I'm having to watch through something that is heavily pixelated and blurry to the point where I can't really read the writing. So Alex Piccolo is in pole position, followed by Andrej Koning in second. Third will be Thomas Wackerbauer. That's such a good name. Kenneth Genty is fourth. Alex Rambeau is fifth on the grid. Stefan Kanitz will be sixth. Jörg Langen, 7. Sebastian Rohan is 8. Achim Kraus is 9, or Achim, sorry, Kraus is 9, Patrick Valente Ferrero 10, Christian Siminik 11, Bart Strubance is 12, Daniel Langenhengemann or Lang Hengman. Sorry, Daniel Lang Hengman is in 13th position. It's one of those names where you look at it and you just go, there's too many letters. And you just will fail regardless, even if it just said Bob. Edgar Otterman, or Osterman, sorry. Otterman. Anyone else used to have one of those? Great. 14th position. Thomas Posh, 15th. Kai Matt is in 16th. Daniel Beck, 17. Marco Wenzatz, Wenzel, sorry, 18. Julian, it's too blurry to even attempt that, 19. Okay. The whole point was so that I didn't actually show the chat room peoples. Oh well. Look, it's a mouse. Well, I suppose now you can actually see the names in lights. Elia Costa's just joined us, actually. We'll be starting in the back of the grid, as will Marco Fiore. The other drivers, we've got Jens Pirkett, 20th, Fabian Puorgis, 21st, Frank Philipsen, 22nd, Andreas Bordo, 23rd, Massimilio Cavriello, 24th, Hoffman, 25, Ricardo Alita, 26, Marco Fiore will be 27, and Elia Costa, 28. And Ralph Dellinger was trying to join there and hasn't quite worked it out. There we go. We don't want to know. I don't even want to know. So I'm assuming that this mod will be available to download and do stuff with at some point. It looks like we'll be moving forward to the race in about 20 seconds. Is that quick enough for me to be able to go and get a drink? Oh, 10 seconds, right. I'll be back in a smidge. traveling along in my automobile.
Attention, good, you're in non-essential personnel, leave the grid now.
I didn't even go out on track, and apparently I'm 23rd on the grid. Loving that. So you can see the qualifying times on the screen. So you can get to grips, follow your favourite German. They're not all German. Oh. Entirely sure why we've got red lights there, but we'll go with it. Let's enjoy some onboard time with Mr. Piccolo. Enjoy the sounds of the mod. Some people are quite explicit about their sounds. Not explicit, that's the wrong word. Apparently people make explicit sounds. Alright, where's my drink? Oh, are we going straight through to Racy? Never. Never, never, never. Well, none of this makes any sense to me whatsoever. So, let me grab it. Oh, yeah, that glass doesn't. Oh, it is. Okay. Cheers, everyone. Oh, click the bottom. I've got myself something that has been fortified. So that I can survive this broadcast of confusion. Oh, that's nice. Nice and strong. Yes, it's Alka Pops.
Are you joking?
Well, I'm not really sure what's going on. I think that we're having our little briefing. I could see if I could try and get the car out with my keyboard. Anyway, while we're waiting for that, let's share a Simon story. What should we go for? Christmas Day was quite good. Oh, microphone in the drink, not good. Christmas Day was good. I got Uncharted 3 for PS3. That was good. My parents seem to have gone a little bit confused, though, because they got me a couple of DVDs, somehow, don't know how, they managed to get them all in Region 1. Obviously, I'm a Brit, we need Region 2. And I thought, actually, you really had to go quite out of your way to make sure that you got American DVDs. And I was like, we couldn't find them anywhere. And they're like really obvious things like the in-betweeners. And you just think, oh, well, hello? How did you miss that one? So I've had to buy myself a multi-region DVD player. Which is good because I like to import random things from random countries so that it throws open the floodgates for that so I can spend even more of my dosh I don't have. My nan phoned up. That was joyous, I'm sure. And proceeded to tell us all that she doesn't plan to be here for next Christmas. We all smiled a little inside. Now what's going on? Have we restarted? Ooh. Oh, by myself. Oh, no, there we go. What else exciting went on? Got quite drunk. I ate a lot. Do you know what, actually, it's been quite interesting. I said, everyone says, have you had a nice Christmas? And they go, yes, I have. Followed by, but I ate a lot. Surely we should all know this by now. This is what Christmas is all about. And apart from giving and receiving, which is good. Don't mind a little bit giving if you get to receive as well. And that motto applies to all walks of life, I think. So I think they're just piddling around on the track, really. Mod does look very good though, so I suggest when this is available, don't know when it is, it might already be available, who knows, go download it. It's the GT3 mod. I didn't even know there was a GT3. There'll be GT3 the game, GTR3 the game, isn't it, by old Binnie Sim. That'd be nice. Okay, so are people actually... doing something here? I'm not sure. Well, there's the order. We can't be on a race, surely. I just don't know anymore. I'm sure I'm warm up. There's red lights still. When the red lights go out, I'll take some interest. You know when you just think, I think I'm going to need it. It's looking very pretty on the screen. I wonder if they're going for like a test formation lap or something. Oh no, we're on a grid. That's nice. The grid will appear on your screen there. I don't think they've quite managed this one right either. It's looking a little bit wee wonky for a griddy. Unless that's what we call a sprint race. And it's all gone horribly wrong. This reminds me of the time when I had to do this through for RDLMS. And I thought the race was go, and it was on a formation lap, and I was getting so excited. And it took me a while. It was probably when I admitted to the world I did need some Prozac. But here is everyone, lined up on the grid. Why? I don't know. So whatever this is, we're getting ready to go for it. Go for it we must. Hopefully not with 3 minutes still left to go. This may take the mick ever so slightly. Is that someone trundling all the way down the... Oh, come on. Who's that? That's awful. Oh. Careful, don't disappear, leader. Piccolo, 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 low, low. Boop, boop, boop. Piccolo, 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 piccolo. Boop, boop, boop. Piccolo, that is a flute, isn't it? New instrument to play with in a broadcast. So, the grid is very pretty. Would like to see some racing action. Oh, we've got... is that a light? No! No way! 2 minutes left! Suddenly those lights make sense. Do you know what? I've never seen that before. In all my years... he says it like he knows what he's talking about. In all of my years of sim racing, I have never seen pretty little lights to a county town. And who is that fidgeting around in the back of the view? Either that or I will just be quite hilariously... There's me! Hello! So we have got, okay, 27 cars then on the grid. That's very confusing. There was more than that earlier. Well, I'm in the middle of the grid. So actually, that is quite good for me, because I think when I've actually attempted a lap, in anger, I don't think I've got to 23rd on the grid before, so yeah, cheers. Ah, right. 30 seconds, and I will stop talking absolute cack. And hopefully, we'll get some racing away. There you can see the grid on the bottom of your screen as we scroll through the positions. 15 seconds to go until the lights begin to come on. We're ready for a 90 minute race here, I think. I hope. Bruno. Don't you just love it when it does that? Now you can see a countdown begin. Oh, it's a 30 minute sprint race. Oh, Jesus. We're off! That is a great start there by Piccolo. Who else is getting off there? Coding's away well too, and those two. Is there anyone else in this race? Those two have blasted away up front. That's taking the absolute BB. As that is... I know who... I was going to say that's Wackenbauer, but it was giving me someone else's name, so it's throwing me off a little bit. But those two have rocketed away. That is an absolute Mickey take as Piccolo leads. Koning then is up to second. Wackenbauer will be third. Kenneth Ginty is up into fourth position. Fifth then is Rambo. Sixth, will be Stefan Kanitz. No one really overtaking anyone. Someone having a look there, that was Rambo getting his angry elf out. Up to ninth there is gone Patrick Ferrero, because he's overtaken somebody. Who's that? It's Munich. They're down into 10th position. And Gino Di Matto there is already out of the race. That is me. And you can see the field there just rounding up down the bottom. Is this the point where they say, actually? Everyone's kind of... I don't know. I'm assuming we'll get a green flag at some point, because Piccolo is just sitting there taking the mick. Ah, I think we're forming a grid. Oh my goodness. Do you know what? Let's just... should we just get drunk? Oops. Here comes the third. I've got this bolt. So, it looks like he's breaking there. Piccolo is looking like being the Pied Piper. He flashes to the crowd. And they give him 2 out of 10 for size, but 10 out of 10 for style as he crosses the line to start off what is hopefully now the sprint race event here. And he's gone in very, very deep there, and Koenig is straight onto the back of him. And they've got both a wiggle on as Wackenbauer there continues to hog third position in the bright yellow car. And then those three have pulled away ever slightly over Rambo, who's gone up into fourth position. So Stallone is at it again. And that is Cone going in very, very deep, and that has allowed Piccolo there to get a smidgy bit of breathing space as the field filter their way through this twisty turning Brno circuit. Everyone else appears to be okay at the moment. Let me just jump on down. Oh, come on. Oh, hang on. Ah. Everyone else appears to be okay. That's, yeah, Pagawa, they're just back at last position. Let's see what's going on up front. Piccolo then leads from Koenig in second. Wackenbauer is third. Fourth position, Mr. Rambo himself looks a little bit under pressure from fifth place. Is that Stefan Kanitz? No, it's Kenneth G and D. And look at the different line he takes. He's swooped up onto the back wing of Rambo there. And I'm quite sure Rambo doesn't want to be mounted from behind, because that would do all kinds of things for his self-image. And Sheensy there, back, very, very feisty indeed, as does the collection of cars going on behind. Over the brow they come. Sheensy trying to go for the outside there. That's never going to work, because unless you've got your car fully alongside, but he's sizing himself up perfectly to have a run down the home straight. There you can see Piccolo has got faster lap after the opening one. And actually, if anything, there now, this is Kanitz having a look at Gene T. Who's that going for gold behind? That is Simunic in 10th position. And 11th, who is that? That's Strubans having a go through. He's got the inside line round the outside of turn one. Good move there by Strubans to get up into the top 10 positions. That's a good move indeed. So looking juicy for him, and immediately sizing up the car in front. Is that Ferrero? I think it may well be, because that's Kraus just up ahead. Yeah, it's Ferrero in 9th position. So that lot continuing to clamber each other up. Everyone else appears to be going okay, although we've got two cars really straggling towards the back of the field there. It's Philipson, they're 23 seconds down, and Di Matteo, they didn't even take the start, so we're already down to just 25 runners and riders remaining. They can see them back end of the top 10 really close together. Fantastic stuff there. The leading trio have pulled away, and you've got there Piccolo, Koenig, Wackenbauer, And who's that off taking an obscurity route? It's Rambo. He's decided he's going to go camouflage down the grassy area, and that's launched him back to sixth position. Watch out, Gene T there. That's far too hot on the brakes for you. But Rambo back in sixth position. I don't even know if his surname is Rambo, but it is now. And he is immediately... Oh, he's immediately too hot on the accelerator, and that's a trip across the gravel. He really does want to go camouflage. Unfortunately, the only one you're doing in there is yourself, and he's going to do an unsafe entry back onto the circuit. He's kicked the curve around into the barrier. There's a good demonstration of the damage mod all there as the rear wing comes off. Now, he's got to wait. Oh, he's retiring it there. The end of the day for Rambo. Well, he won't get a sequel out of that, will he? As he drops out of the race. Now there are just 24 still. Piccolo leads the way quite handsomely now from Koenig in second position. Wackenbauer is in third, being caught now by fourth place Kenneth Genty. The gap now down to just a couple of tenths as everyone starts to sort themselves out. Kanitz is up to sixth. Who's that in sixth? It is Rowan there, who's had a very quiet but effective drive so far in the bogey green car. Kraus then in seventh position is leading this little gaggle of cars. Who have we got here? It's Ferrero, then it's... Ferrero Rocher. Ferrero, Valentine Ferrero, Simunek. And who's that in 11th position that's just leading round the next battle of cards? It's Ulsterman there in 11th position, leading a great gaggle. There, but trying to just showcase this purring mod. Yeah, showcasing site for GT3. Is that Strubans there getting past Simunek again there for the ninth position? As the leaders cross the line again. We're nearly at the 1/3 mark already. Time wise, it's just a 30 lap race. As that's a great collection of cars, they're just crossing the line. And it's Ferrero versus Strubance, and Ferrero there almost being scared out wide. The Strubance there bounces through and takes another position. He is lethal down into turn one. He's got real good pace, and that's now put Valentin Ferrero right on his back foot there. Patrick now having to defend.